Next speaker is Mahendra Thudi, I hope I pronounced that correctly, from ICRISAT here in India. And he's going to talk about enhancing drought tolerance in chickpea using genomics approaches.
Good afternoon, everybody. First of all, I would like to thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity to present our work on enhancing drought tolerance in chickpea using genomics approaches. So, in recent years, concern has been raising about the drought, increase of frequency as well as severity of drought. So when there is a insufficient soil moisture to meet the needs of a particular crop at a particular time, this is called agricultural drought. So every degree increase in temperature because of the climate changes will lead to enhanced drought situations across the world. So by 2040, the global superpowers such as United States of America, China, and India faces a lot of water stress, and by 2050 we need to produce 69% more food to meet the growing populations across the world. To give a brief overview of chickpea is the second most important food legume cultivated on residual soil moisture globally, and it is cultivated in about 59 countries, and India is the largest producer as well as largest consumer of chickpea. Although chickpea is cultivated on in 59 countries on about 13 million hectares, the productivity is less than 1 ton per hectare. The reason being, like, there are several abiotic stresses like drought, heat, and salinity, and biotic stresses like pod borer, fusarium wilt, and Ascochyta blight are the major constraints to chickpea production. Chickpeas are normally grown in on residual soil moisture condition during the month of November to February. So if you see, there is an increase in temperature during the pod filling as well as seed setting stage. This is what we call terminal drought. Hence, terminal drought is the most important constraint that leads to production losses in chickpea. So it is very important that we develop climate resilient crops to meet the food and nutritional demands of growing population. Until few years ago, we have very few molecular markers and low genetic density maps, as well as we did not have appropriate germplasm lines or such as mapping populations or precise phenotyping facilities to understand the genetics of the trait. And also our poor understanding of the trait because of non-availability of trait associated markers, especially drought being the complex trait. At ICRISAT, for understanding the variability among the root trait, what we have done, we have developed this root screening facility, that is polyvinyl chloride cylinder culture system. And in this system, we can screen a large set of germplasm lines. In a study conducted by Kashiwagi et al., we have screened mini core collection and identified under severe drought stress condition a significant positive relationship of root length density with the yield. And several germplasm lines were screened in this mini core collection, and we have identified germplasm lines like ICC4958 and ICC 8261 with longer root length density, and ICC 283 and ICC 1882 with shorter root length. So based on screening of the mini core collection, we have developed two intraspecific mapping populations that that are phenotypically and phenotypically different for this root length variations. So the mapping populations contained about 260 recombinant inbred lines. You can see a large variation for these different root length density as well as root dry weight for these two mapping populations. Until 2005, we have very few molecular markers in case of chickpea. We have very few SSR markers, and we don't have any SNP markers, and we don't have any DART markers. Equisat, in collaboration with several partners in national and international level, we have developed several molecular markers during these last 10 years. And so we have primarily genotyped the markers that we have developed with the parental lines, and then the polymorphic markers were used to genotype the mapping populations, that both intraspecific mapping populations that we have developed. And we developed genetic maps for both intraspecific mapping populations, and we have about 241 markers on ICC4958 and ICC1882, and in case of ICC283 and A261, we have mapped 168 markers. We have also constructed a consensus genetic map using both the intraspecific maps, and we can see a great correlation for the marker position in the consensus map for both by using these two intraspecific maps. We have phenotyped the both mapping populations for 20 different drought tolerance related traits like root traits, morphological traits, and yield and yield component traits in about 1 to 7 seasons and in 1 to 5 locations. Using the genotyping information and phenotyping information, we have identified a QTL hotspot. We call this as QTL hotspot because several drought tolerance related traits are mapped in this particular region. And we have, this QTL hotspot was initially identified in ICC4958 and ICC1882 mapping population. And then we have also identified the similar same genetic region or genomic region in the other mapping population. This shows that this genomic region is very important in enhancing drought tolerance, and hence as a part of Tropical Legumes project funded by Melinda Gates Foundation, we have integrated this QTL region into Elite cultivar, which is a leading variety in India, JG11. We have taken up 3 backcross generations and 2 selfing generations. At each generation, we have conducted foreground selection and background selection using SSR and AFLP markers. And we have identified 29 backcross progenies which are having enhanced root length density. If you see here, we can see some of the progenies which are having higher root length density compared to both recipient parent as well as donor parent. And ultimate aim of any breeder or scientist is to enhance the yield. So whether this increase in root length density is really translated into the yield or not, for that what we have done, we have conducted trials in the rain fed as well as irrigated situation, and identified that several of the lines have enhanced yield for about 12% increase in yield under rain fed condition and 24% increase in yield under irrigated condition. Based on this success story, we also integrated the QTL region into several cultivars, elite cultivars in India as well as Africa like Kenya and Ethiopia. So you can see a similar kind of enhancement in the yield as well as biomass. Finally, thanks to all the colleagues, and Dr. Varshney is behind this particular, he is the leader of this particular project. Thanks for your attention.
Thank you, Mahinda.